time, long branches of sacral plexus, only two nerves. First nerve, that is nervus cutaneus femoris posterior. It's a posterior aspect of the thigh. The same continues to upper posterior aspect of the leg and gives nervi clunium inferioris. Nervi clunium inferior. Do you remember nervi clunium superior? Superior. And nervi clunium medii, who remember? They are dorsal branches, first our first classes, dorsal branches of upper three lumbar nerves. They give nervi clunium superior, and dorsal branches of sacral nerves gives nervi clunium medii. And now nervi clunium inferior start from nervus cutaneus femoris posterior. And another long branch, that is sciatic nerve, nervus ischiaticus, together with nervus cutaneus femoris posterior, both of them leaves pelvis through infrapiriform foramen. And sciatic nerve, nervus ischiaticus, supplies posterior muscles of the thigh. They are musculus semitendinosus, semimembranosus, long head of biceps, musculus biceps, femoris, and posterior aspect of musculus adductor magnus. Today you said that adductor magnus receives innervation from nervus obturatorius, and next time the same, you will know that sciatic nerves, the same supplies musculus adductor magnus. Next. After that, nervus ischiaticus subdivides into nervus tibialis and nervus peroneus communis. Nervus tibialis goes to popliteal fossa, and here it is, it has most superficial position under the skin, that is tibial nerve, nervus tibialis, deepest position in popliteal fossa, that is popliteal artery, and between nerve and artery we have popliteal vein, nerve, then vein, and then artery. From superficial to deep in popliteal fossa. Clear it is? That is topography of vessels and nerves in popliteal fossa. From here, tibial nerve goes into the canal. That is cruropopliteal canal. Yes, canalis cruropopliteus. And before it's enter into this canal, tibial nerve gives cutaneus branch, nervus cutaneus sura medialis. That is nervus tibialis, tibial nerve. Here it is nervus cutaneus sura medialis. And this nerve joined together with nervus cutaneus sura lateralis from common peroneal nerve, nervus peroneus communis. And this one is nervus cutaneus sura lateralis. These two nerves, medial and lateral, join together and makes nervus suralis, nervus suralis. And nervus suralis supplies lateral, posterior lateral aspect of the leg and goes around malleolus lateralis and goes to dorsal surface of the foot and continues into nervus cutaneus dorsalis lateralis and goes to fifth toe. Here it is fourth, third, second, and first. That is, supplies the lateral aspect of the fifth toe. That is nervus cutaneus dorsalis lateralis from nervus suralis. That is continuation of nervus suralis on the foot. Then, tibial nerve. Nervus tibialis pass into canalis cruropopliteus, supplies muscles of the leg, musculus gastrocnemius, musculus soleus, musculus popliteus, and musculus plantaris. And it gives branch nervus interosseus cruris. Nervus interosseus cruris. And this nerve supplies deep muscles of the leg, musculus tibialis posterior, musculus flexor hallucis longus, and musculus flexor digitorum longus. Yes. After that, tibial nerve surround malleolus medialis, and on plantar surface of the foot it subdivides into nervus plantaris medialis and nervus plantaris lateralis. Nervus plantaris medialis and nervus plantaris lateralis. Nervus plantaris medialis supplies medial muscles, that is, abductor hallucis, flexor only, medial head of flexor hallucis brevis. The same supplies musculus flexor digitorum brevis and subdivides into three common digital plantar nerves, nervi digitalis plantaris communis, and these three common nerves subdivides into seven proper digital nerves. Nervi digitalis plantaris proprii. The same it supplies first and second musculus lumbricalis. That is the same like nervus medianus on the hand. And lateral nerve, it supplies lateral muscles, musculus abductor digiti minimi, flexor digiti minimi, and subdivides into superficial and deep. Superficial branch continues into three proper digital plantar nerve, nervi digitalis plantaris proprii, and deep branch continues to all interossal muscles, third and fourth musculi lumbricalis, adductor hallucis, and lateral head of musculus flexor hallucis brevis. The same like what? Like ulnar nerve on the hand. That is tibial nerve, nervus tibialis. Now, nervus peroneus communis. Nervus peroneus communis supplies musculus, short head of musculus biceps femoris, then continues into the canal, canalis musculi peroneus superior, superior canal, canalis musculi peroneus superior, and subdivides into superficial and deep, superficial and deep nerve. Superficial nerve leaves canalis musculi peroneus superior and subdivides into nervus cutaneus dorsalis medialis and nervus cutaneus dorsalis intermedius. The same superficial nerve supplies musculus peroneus longus and brevis. Sometimes nervus peroneus communis supplies these muscles, musculus peroneus, longus and peroneus brevis. Nervus cutaneus dorsalis medialis. Nervus cutaneus dorsalis medialis supplies medial aspect of the big toe and space between second and third. Not supplies space between first and second. Nervus cutaneus dorsalis intermedius. Nervus cutaneus dorsalis intermedius goes to opposite side of fourth and fifth, the same third and fourth, and second and third. And now nervus peroneus profundus. Nervus peroneus profundus, deep peroneal nerve. It supplies anterior muscles, tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus and extensor digitorum longus. And after that, deep peroneal nerve goes to dorsal surface and subdivides into two nerves, nervi digitalis dorsalis. Nervi digitalis dorsalis. And supplies opposite sides of first and second toes. It is not so easy like on the hand. Here it is difficult. That is all. Two nerves. Posterior femoral and sciatic nerve next time. And now we try to see on the corp. Nervus cutaneus femoris posterior supplies posterior aspect of the thigh, leg, nervi clunium inferior, and rami perinei goes to the skin of perineum. The same from nervus cutaneus femoris posterior. Now, nervus ischiadicus supplies posterior muscles, semitendinosus, semimembranosus, long head of biceps, and posterior aspect of musculus adductor magnus. After that, nervus ischiadicus subdivides into tibial and nervus peroneus communis. Nervus tibialis in popliteal fossa, more superficial position, and continues into canalis cruropopliteus. From tibial nerve, we can see nervus cutaneus sura medialis, and from peroneus communis we have nervus cutaneus sura lateralis. These two nerves join together, and from here start nervus suralis. Nervus suralis surround malleolus lateralis and goes to dorsal surface as nervus cutaneus dorsalis lateralis. Nervus peroneus communis, it supplies musculus, a short head of biceps, musculus flex, biceps femoris, continues into canalis muscula peroneus superior, subdivides into superficial and deep branches. Nervus peroneus superficialis and nervus peroneus profundus. Here it is superficial nerve. Nervus peroneus superficialis and deep. Nervus peroneus profundus. Nervus peroneus superficialis subdivides into nervus cutaneus dorsalis medialis and nervus cutaneus dorsalis intermedius. And nervus peroneus profundus supplies musculus tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus and extensor digitorum longus. And continuation of this nerve, nervus peroneus profundus, is nervi digitalis dorsalis. Here it is. Nervi digitalis dorsalis goes to space opposite sides of first and second toes. That is all what we can see on the leg and on the